When God gave the nations, the church, he gave that nation the answer to their problems. Because God's kingdom is not just a spiritual place. What you don't know is that God's kingdom is a country.
There's power in knowledge. There's power in information. There's power in knowing something. If you know what has been written concerning health, it is easy to claim healing. If you know what has been written concerning finance, it is easy to claim wealth. If you know what has been written concerning business, there are words in the scriptures that have...
You are on to a life transforming experience as Pastor Prince Abbott brings you God's word with deep insight and power. God bless you.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. So we lift our holy hands in wonder, singing, blessed be thy name. So blessed be thy name. Let me hear you sing it one. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised and So we lift our holy hands in one accord. Oh, singing, blessed be thy name. Oh, blessed be thy name. God is oh, a glorious God, and God is oh, a miracle. Time to say, and God is,
yeah.
Oh, a miracle worker. My God is, yeah.
God is a glorious God.
Father, we give you praise. give you praise. Thank you, Father, because there are miracles already in this house. God just said to me that there's somebody who is longing for a deeper encounter with Him. He is satisfying that test. In this service, you're going to leave this place and you're going to find out that there's a new dimension. You're going to swim in the new dimension. I heard God just say that in my spirit right now. A new dimension, a new walk with Him, a new fellowship of the Spirit, a new fellowship of the Spirit. Father, we give you praise, we give you praise. We give a praise, we give a praise. Oh, a glorious God. Thank you, Father. As your word come forth right now, I pray, Lord, that you give us a new sense of living. Give us a sense of existence. Let our lives not just be an existing one, but let it be a life worth living. A life of purpose, a life of impact, a life of result. We give you praise and thanks because we know your presence is here with us already. You are the one who built this whole world. You're the one who built the systems of the whole world. We pray, Lord, as a church, that you would teach us right now how to control our environment, how to be the people in charge of our society. We give you praise. We give you thanks. Hallowed be your name forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can I hear your loudest amen?
Amen.
Let me hear your believing amen.
Amen.
Okay, find somebody just close to you. Shake hands with the person and just say good evening to the person. Hallelujah. Just shake hands with somebody sitting close to you. Shake hands with somebody. Shake hands with somebody. Greet somebody for coming to church this evening. Hallelujah. God bless you. May have your seat. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, there are a couple of things this evening we are going to be looking at, and amen. You know, church is a school. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Church is a school, and it's good when we of these things and all that. Hallelujah. Last Sunday we started a talk on the Human Development Index. Hallelujah. I don't know how many of you were blessed in service last Sunday. Let me see your hands up if you were blessed in service. Hallelujah. And we're going to be doing a continuation on that. I think last Sunday I was able to show you that there are few persons who are making impacts in life. Just few. I was able to show you some statistics of about 2% of people who are relevant in life, why the rest of the 98% are people who are termed not relevant. Actually, only 2% of the human population are living. 98% are existing. There's a difference between living and existence. If you are existing, then you are one of the definitions of matter. What is matter? Anything that has weight and can occupy space. So 98% of humanity are actually matter. That's why you see there's a whole lot of matters in the world, because this 98% of the human population are the ones creating problems. So there's plenty of matters everywhere. Problems to solve. There are a lot of problems. These problems are created by the 98% people who would not move from the crowd and join the college of the few who are making things happen. One of the things happening in these last days is that there's a move from the usual way of doing things in the church now into the unusual. And the people who will be relevant in this age are people who are aware of what God is doing and people who can embrace the new move of God. God is not a monumental God. God is not a static God. God is a transitional God. He is not a traditional God. If you want to follow God the way you have always followed Him, you are going to fail big time. The men who would succeed in this, listen, failure rate is high now, whether you believe it or not. There's a lot of failure rate is increasing by the day. Check your society. And yesterday, I think I was driving and in the night, so policemen stopped me and they were asking, where are you coming from? So I told them I'm coming from Ikwa. I went to check on some things. We're having a crusade. I said, okay, you're a pastor. I said, yes, I'm a pastor. He said, please, pastor, pray for us. Pray for this country. We don't know where things are going to anymore. So got into a journey on the study of some of the things I said sharing with you last Sunday. If you were here last Sunday, you understand. If you really took note of the things I was teaching you, some of you must have had a shift in paradigm. Some of you must have had shift in your thinking. Some of you must have had shift in the way you used to see things. One of the biggest revelations you can have in life is a revelation of who you are. And the revelation of why you are here. That's one of the biggest revelations that can change your entire life. The day you discover why you are born, and the day you discover why on earth, that day your entire existence will change. I was talking to some people one day. I think it was in a barbing saloon. I just started talking. We're seeing a TV program, and it was Pastor Adeboye speaking that evening. And I think he had millions of people. One of those Holy Ghost Congress or something. Millions of people were everywhere, scattered everywhere. And you know what he was saying that day? Stories on how he evolved from poverty to wealth, from obscurity to influence. He was just telling stories of his humble days. I didn't see him open one passage of the Bible from when he started preaching to when he finished. But the whole place was packed full. Packed full. And I said, what? What is this? What is Pastor saying that has made these millions of people gathered? He was talking about okra soup. How one day there was no food in the house and they had to look for okra soup. And you know, a couple of things. And I said, is it okra soup these millions of people traveled from afar to come and listen to? I said, okay, what is that thing that has made Adeboye the kind of man he is? That millions of people can gravitate all over the world to come and listen to him. He doesn't scream. He's just talking. And people are the ones screaming. He's not making noise. He's making news while the crowd makes the noise. So what does he know? Okay, what is he doing to produce that level of results? And on Sunday, I showed you a pyramid. Get this, oh. I told you the first pyramid or the first layer of your human development starts with teaching, training, or knowledge. And this one makes for just 10% of your total human development. It doesn't matter what you learn, my friend. Don't think knowledge is what makes people successful. Because someone once said, knowledge is power. I said, it's not true. That definition long expired. Knowledge is no longer power. Because there are a lot of people who are too knowledgeable. A lot of them everywhere, knowledgeable. Have you seen Christians who have sound knowledge of the Bible? Plenty revelation of the Bible. But you look around them, there's still so much of failure hanging over them. You look around them and you see the highest level of indiscipline. They are the ones who break laws in society more. I think on Sunday I showed you how, recently I've been researching, high level of accident rate in Nigeria. Majority of them took place in the east. The east, the south, south, southwest, and all that. Go and check the ones who are driving the buses and getting involved in accidents. Christians. Most of them too knowledgeable. I've sat with men who, when they speak, I know this guy's problem is not that he doesn't know this thing. This lady's problem is not that he doesn't know this thing. But it doesn't produce enough success. It's just 10%. Now, there's this other one. Because some of you think this is what Adeboye has that is making him succeed. Some of you think this is what Bill Gates has that is making him succeed. This is not it. I want to show you how to take charge of your environment now. Because we have done church for many years. We have done Christianity for many years. But the results are so, what do I use? So minute. Little or nothing to show. Christians in Nigeria are about 40 million. That's what 40 million professing Christians in Nigeria. Yet you look around our society, it doesn't look as though the Christianity we profess or practice has an impact on society. This morning or this evening, while I was driving out of my house, I had to call somebody to come and move his car before I moved mine. And of course, there were bottles all over behind the car. Plenty of bottles of beer, bottles of alcohol, star, treat, all those kind of stuff. I had to go and call, please, can you come move this stuff? And these guys were sitting by the side. They had their clothes off. Some, just their singlet. A lot of them, what were they doing? They were drinking. Good and star and all of those stuff. And I looked at the man's car who parked the car in front of my own. You know, behind my own. There was a sticker. And guess what? Church sticker. The guy who was sitting by the corner drinking and having his fun with his girlfriends and all that had a car with a sticker that depicts he's a Christian. So go to preach to that guy. He tells you, I go to church. I know the Bible. He quotes John 3:16. He knows it though, but this is at the level here. Teach him. Just 10%. The next one I showed you makes 40% of your human development. That one is called discipline / character development. That's the one that has kept me going. I longed to move away from this side, this one called teaching, because if you know a thing and you can't do that thing, this is what you are lacking. If you know something and you are not able to put what you know to work, this is what you are lacking. Discipline. Now, this one alone is 40%. This is what makes success happen. So, okay, I think before I continue, let me show you something from the scriptures. Go to the book of Matthew chapter 6 quickly. Let me show you something. Matthew chapter 6, verse 10. Now, most of you, you will need to allow these things to sink. You have not even heard this thing. Go and get the tapes. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Get the tape of last Sunday. After this service, get this tape. Listen to it and keep listening to it until it sinks. Matthew chapter 6. Look at verse 10. Okay, let's see verse 9. Pray then in this way. That's Jesus talking. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. What is God's kingdom? See the wrong mindset a lot of Christians have had about God's kingdom. It's a place we go to for being good Christians, and when we die, we go there. That's the kind of idea a lot of Christians have about the kingdom of God. But that same kingdom we are struggling to go to, we are living right to go to, is the same kingdom Jesus said when we pray. Let us pray according to this pattern. He said, thy kingdom come. You are striving to go there. Jesus said, pray for that kingdom to come. So the question is, where are you going to? Okay, have you also asked, why did Christ leave you here? After he saved man, why didn't he take everybody at once? Why did he leave you here? For what purpose did he leave you here? Thy kingdom come. So the question now is, what is God's kingdom? Now I want to move to the third layer. You know, this was where I started, or this was where I stopped. I want to take out time and teach you on this last one. Because the reason why society is failing is not because we don't have knowledgeable Christians. No. It's not because we don't have maybe some Christians who are disciplined and who have character. I know a lot of Christians also who have good discipline and good character. Now let me say this to you, that teaching and discipline takes care of personal success. You hear what I'm saying? It takes care of personal success. But God is not so interested in your personal success than he's interested in societal success. God is not so interested in the success of an individual than he's interested in the success of society. Now, at this level, this is 50%. What you have here now is environment. Environment. Look at the progression. This one has more. Now, teaching can influence a man's life, can change a man's mindset, can change a man's, can upgrade a man's knowledge. Teaching can take care of that. Discipline can help a man become successful. But this is not what changes society. Because environment, if Christians don't understand how to control their environment, their discipline plus their teaching will not survive here. I think this thing is too hard. I don't know how else to break this thing. I'm trying to see if I can move you guys from children's bread now to something else that you can, you know, that can help you mature fast. Because that's the realm I'm living in now. I'm going to be giving some literal examples of the things going on in your society so you understand what I'm talking about. God's kingdom is not a place you go to when you give your life to him and die. God's kingdom is a system. When God created Eden, what God replicated on earth was his kingdom. And that kingdom is a set of systems. God created the earth to be a prototype of his kingdom. Then he created man to be a prototype of himself. I don't know if I should leave this teaching for another time. I don't know. Oh God, give me grace to pass this message across. I'm going to take that again. God made the earth to be a prototype. Listen to me. This earth you are talking about can be reclaimed. This society where it looks like there's a whole lot of crime, there's a whole lot of problems, there's a whole lot of issues going on, it can be reclaimed if believers know how to move out of this level to this level, this one called environment. Because you see, we have a lot of churches around the society. In Abakaliki alone, I think we have more churches than we have more schools. We have more churches than we have more hospitals. We have more churches than we have more government houses. We have more churches than we have more, call them. A lot of them. And people go to churches every day. Just go to St. Mulumba here. You'll be amazed at the crowd you see. Go to which, mention their names. Go to Anglican. You'll be amazed by the crowd you see. Come back to society on Monday. You'll be shocked. You'll be shocked whether there's a Christian clicking. You'll be shocked whether there's a Christian in Nigeria. Why? We have majored emphasis on teaching and training. We have majored emphasis on discipline and character. We have not taken time to study environment. That is where the devil is living now. So God's kingdom is what takes care of environment. Environment is society. Now, what is God's kingdom? God's kingdom is a set of systems. Now, let me say this to you, and let me say it, I mean it very well. In the whole world, only 2% of the world's population know how to build systems. And only these 2% control the whole world. They don't need to run around. They stay at a spot, organize a system, network the whole world together, and do whatever they want to do with the world. Just 2% know how to build systems that controls their environment. So God's kingdom is not just a spiritual place. It's not just a place you go to when you die because you're a Christian. God's kingdom is a system. And if the church will make any visible impact in society, the church must know how to build and deploy systems. Somebody may be asking, what kind of system is Pastor talking about? What kind of system? Let me show you. Matthew chapter 6 again. Look at verse 33. I'm not going to finish this teaching. I'm just trying to lay foundation. Then maybe we'll continue some other times. Verse 33. The same Matthew chapter 6, 33. He said, but seek first his kingdom and his righteousness. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Mm-hmm. And all other things will be added. And all other things will be added. Just take those two words, the kingdom and his righteousness. What is the kingdom of God? The kingdom of God is what? Can you talk to me? The kingdom of God is what? Is a set of systems. Then what is his righteousness? His values. His principles. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. That is his systems. And his righteousness. The values and principles of that kingdom. So let's take a picture of Eden. Eden was an organized society with a set of values and principles governing it. When the devil came into Eden and took the CFO of that society and polluted the values of that society, God came back, drove man away from it, and took Eden back. Of course, from that day, society landed itself into chaos, all kinds of pollutions. Because of the fall of Adam, all kinds of pollutions were infiltrated into society. The systems of the world became the systems of the devil. Now, when Jesus came as a remedy plan to salvage man, one of the things he came to do was to reintroduce the systems of God back to society and introduce the values of that kingdom back to society. So let's look at Eden. Eden had some set of systems. Eden had an aquatic life. How many of you have heard about the aquatic system? Okay, let's look at some natural systems. You know, I'm trying to teach you how to become like God. Because if you learn the ways of God, or if you learn the person of God, and you don't learn his ways, you cannot be like him. You won't produce the kind of result he has produced. I've studied the way God functions, and it's amazing. Do you know what God created? The word he created is a word of systems. Systems are around you, yet most of you don't know it. Is a world of system. Every problem you see in society is created by a system. How many of you have seen Bill Gates? Have you seen Bill Gates before? You've seen Bill Gates face to face. Have you seen him? Bill Gates has been able to sit at a spot, created a system that is either causing problems or solving problems in the world. God was the first man to build a system. What he built called Eden was a system. He was the first man to build aquatic system. Everything God made, he made in systems. He put systems in place. There's a system responsible for controlling flight. What do you call it? Aerodynamic system. There's a system responsible for, what do you call this one? For balance in society. What is it called? Ecosystem. Now, do you know everything in life is interdependent? Any part of the ecosystem now you tamper with will affect something somewhere. If it's a tree you cut, maybe one animal somewhere dies. You wonder how bad, how related are they? That's why I tell people, some of these guys who want to be on their own, watch them. Because God made everything to be interdependent. You want to do life on your own and succeed, you're going to have to struggle. Because God didn't create people that way. He even said it's not good for man to be alone. So he made everything to be interdependent. Everything has a connection to something. So if it's one animal you kill somewhere, something somewhere dies. It's called ecosystem. That's why you see in developed nations, they don't play with things like that. They tell you, don't kill these animals. You don't cut down that tree, even if you have to cut. Oh, yeah, grow it again. Is it called afforestation or what? That's afforestation. You have to grow it again. Plant the seed of that tree and grow it back. There's balance. One time I was watching Natural Geo Channel and I asked, these sharks that are killing people, people go to do skating on water and all that, and sharks carry them and kill them. I said, does it mean US doesn't have a technology for killing all these sharks? And somebody said to me, Pastor, it can't happen. I said, why? He said, any of these things you kill now will affect balance somewhere. So they preserve those things. He said, those harmful sharks you're seeing there, there are some more harmful fishes, small fishes in the water. If you put your hook there and catch those fishes, they have this natural poison in them. Catch it, go and kill it and eat it, you will die. So those sharks are inside there to arrest such fishes and kill them, eat them. That's their job. They concentrate on those harmful fishes. So I wonder, why did they not kill the sharks? No, kill the sharks. You'll be the one dying. Because there will be no more sharks to eat those harmful poisonous fishes you would have eaten and died. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? That's the kind of God we serve. And that's the man who was able to put these systems together. God is a system, is a systemic God. He functions by systems. He never does a thing until... Oh, kabokoboko, shake it. Okay, let me show you this. God has never created any other rain aside the first rain he created. Okay, go to the book of Genesis. When he created the heavens and the earth, what happened? The Bible said that the whole earth was filled with waters. Is that correct? I traveled one time on air. I don't know how many times some of you study some of the things God has done. I was in the air traveling. Very far journey for hours. Do you know... You travel to a level where you begin to imagine, is this how intelligent God can be? Hi! From the very minute, one time, I entered the plane. I was observing this thing. I said, okay, how can this thing fly up and hang there and not fall down? Do you know there's a level that plane flies up to? And what holds that plane? Is a system put in space. That is, there's a level you get into. You go beyond human existence. And you can come down from that plane at that level. And you won't fall. You can sit down and be drinking tea. At that level, it's called the level of no life. That's the second heaven. That's where demons actually are. Some of these territorial powers, these principalities and all those powers in high places, that's where you can get in there and you are walking. You can walk, you can do, and you are up. Oh, you will fall. When God created this world, the whole place was filled with waters. God actually parted some and moved it somewhere. Some of them at Lagos Bar Beach. Some of them are the Atlantic Ocean. Some of them Pacific. Some of them Indian Ocean. Some of them Mediterranean Sea and all of those stuff. He moved some of this water that occupied the whole earth and put it somewhere. Then he moved some. Because this land you have now, this dry land you have all around you, water occupied it. The ones you are seeing that is dried now, the question is, where did the water go to? He took that other part of the water and suspended it up in the sky. So you look up clouds. Hey, clouds. You don't know those things were water God took from this place. He just put it there. Then he put a system that makes that water fall periodically. God has never created another water. Do you know, even when this water drops now, when it falls to the ground, God who It's a system. What's that system that is responsible for heat, energy, and all that? It's called what? Solar system that is responsible for light. It gives photosynthesis. That one is responsible for growing your plant. The chlorophyll green pigmentation that helps your flower grows and all that, photosynthesis. The system responsible is solar system. That system also is what is responsible for getting that water, dehydrating water from the earth crust back to space, back to the clouds. There's never a time God has said, okay, rain has finished falling, water has finished falling. There's no other place we can get water from another. Mm-mm. He has never complained. He put a system in place so that when this water comes down, it also goes back again. What do you call it? System. It's called evaporation. Distillation. It goes back. I can keep on and I can go on and on mentioning some of these systems. Okay, look at your human body. You have what you call the human system. You have about 12 of them. You have the respiratory system. You have the reproductive system. You have the, what do you call them? Circulatory system. What? Digestive system. You have the, give me, you know them. What? Nervous system. Do you know this nervous system? Nervous system. Actually, your whole body is wired up. Completely. From your head down to your whatever. Everything is wired up. God took wires and fuel everywhere in your body. And took all these wires and he put it in a control circuit box. Called the brain. Every part of your body links up to the brain. So, if something touches you now, you call it stimuli or sensation. Anything touches you here now. The first place the message registers is not your leg. It is here the thing registers first. The wire responsible for that part of the body that has been tickled transmits information quickly back to the brain. The brain processes that information and sends it back to you in a split of seconds. What is amazing is that it does not take half a second. It doesn't take half a second for that information to be transmitted. So, I just touch you now. It doesn't take 2 minutes for that slap to travel to the brain. The moment I touch you, message has been transmitted. That pain you feel automatically has already been processed in no second time. Processed in no second time and sent back to that part and you felt that pain. That is what human beings studied and built what you call the World Wide Web. So you stay, you don't know. The world, for instance, of information, communication, is connected together. I can be in a back clicker now. And I just hook up with somebody in Texas. I've been doing, just in Texas now, Dallas, Texas. And I'm talking with somebody. Just one email. I type. I click. It doesn't take half a second. The moment I post that information, it gets to that other guy's system in the US in half a second. The same way I pinched you and your brain transmitted that thing and sent it back. That is how human beings studied human system, nervous system. Just one part of what God built. That's what one human being studied. And the whole world is crazy about World Wide Web, internet. Whereas this whole internet is a component called the nervous system. The same thing with your cars. Open your bonnet now. Everything in your car is hooked up to the bonnet. All the mechanical functionalities of your car hooked up to the bonnet. Nowadays, I take my car maybe for servicing and all that. Maybe it's the trafficator that is not working. They don't go and losing the light. They go to the bonnet. Go and check. Nervous system. Everything is wired up to that place. Can stay on my car. I'm driving. And on my dashboard, everything happening outside is showing me. The question is, if God functions that way, why are Christians not functioning that way? That is what the devil studied, and he has taken over this place, environment. That is what the devil studied. And he was able to take charge of the environment, take charge of society. Now, teaching and discipline is like what happens to, for instance, let me give you an instance. If you enter a plane now, and people are sick. After this service, I'm going to pray for sick people now. People are sick. And I come into the plane. And I start laying hands on everybody. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed, be healed, be healed. Get healed, get healed, get healed. Get healed, get healed. And everybody gets healed in the plane. The question is, I've done a good job, but I've not done a very great job. Because that people in the plane may have been healed. The question now is, what if the plane itself is sick? So you can begin to imagine what happens when you have a society of Christians who are knowledgeable and Christians who are disciplined and they have good characters, but the society itself is sick. Because that plane is going to take all those guys who have been healed up into the air. But if the engine of that society, if the engine of that plane is faulty, just give that plane a few seconds. Everybody in that plane that are healthy will crash with the plane. So we have a society where they are good Christians. They've been taught, they are knowledgeable. They have good characters and discipline. But they don't know how to build systems to control environment. That is what Facebook has done. Because Facebook is just one guy who understood how God functions. Though he was not a Christian, he deployed a principle God puts in motion. And he's able to control a whole network of people. Just one system called Facebook. Okay, let's take entertainment. What's this my friend's name? Ben Bruce, Silverbed. What do you call Silverbed? You think it's a channel, it's a system. The mistake Christians made, or the mistake the church made, is that we didn't understand the place of building systems. So we were gathering and clapping. And that's the mistake a lot of people in my generation are making now. There's a church shift going on now. There's a shift in the paradigm taking place now. But so many persons have been so used to the old ways of doing things. And we have not been able to forestall significant changes in society. Because we think that changes come by shouting. How many times have you seen the devil shouting in your ears? How many times does he appear to you? He's somewhere resting. He's, my friend, that guy doesn't have time to run to and fro again. Somewhere resting and cooling up. He just pulls systems. The same way God functions. You know, he was with him. So what did the devil do? He just came, studied what God did, and turned the values upside down. It's the same mechanism. Hello? If I put tomatoes inside a blender, it will blend tomatoes. If I take the tomatoes out and put onions, what will it blend? So what do you call blender? System. So the devil took the same systems God put in place and put the wrong values inside. So where God's kingdom says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, the devil sought that same kingdom but put unrighteousness in it. So where God says, don't do, he said, do. Where God says, do, he said, don't do. He turns the thing upside down. But it's the same system. So now, those of you who think media is a system for the devil, it's not the system that belongs to it. It's God's system. God put it there. Oh, let me show you a scripture. Then I close you. Because at the end of the day, we are going to find out, what do we do as Christians now to make our world a better place? Any problem you see in society was caused by a system. And the way to solve the problem is to create an alternative system. It's as simple as that. Your society is made up of systems. Politics is a system. Economy is a system. Under economy, you have subsystems. Capitalism is a system. Democracy is a system. Who created democracy? Somebody created it. Who created capitalism? A system of economy. Who created socialism? Who created communism? Who created feudalism? Who created all these systems? Somebody sat them and wrote them out and created them. And these systems are controlling human beings. We live in systems. Who created them? You think they just came down from nowhere? They were created. They were created. Somebody created them. Let me show you Proverbs chapter 3. Proverbs chapter 3. Let's look at verse 19 quickly. The Lord by wisdom. By what? Wisdom. Founded the earth. By understanding, he established the heavens. So see how God built the whole earth? By wisdom. He built the earth. By understanding, he established it. That's the Father we call God. That's the man we call our God. That is how he functions. By understanding, he founded or established the earth. By wisdom, he found the earth. By understanding, he established it. So the way to take control of the earth is by wisdom. Wisdom, systems building. Any wrong you see in society is not hopeless. Every wrong has a solution. Every problem has a solution. But how do we create that solution? By settling down and building our own alternative systems. It takes wisdom. Go to the book of 2 Corinthians. That's the last scripture I will show you. And I'll say a few things. I will close. 2 Corinthians chapter, I think that's chapter 10. Yes. Chapter 10 and verse 5. I'll read it quickly. We are destroying speculations and every lofty thing raised up against the knowledge of God, and we are taking every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. I need somebody with another translation to read it. Let's get more translations. Somebody quickly. Give somebody the mic very fast to read that stuff. Yes, I need a different translation. Maybe the Pure King James version. The Pure King James. Yes, read it, man.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Casting down imaginations.
Casting down imaginations.
And every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God.
Mm-hmm.
And bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Praise the Lord.
I don't know how you read your Bibles and understand them. Casting down every imagination and bringing down every high thing that exalts itself above the knowledge of the God, of the Lord. What are those imaginations and high things that seem to have exalted itself above the church and above the knowledge of God? Should I show you one of it? Pornography. Should I show you another one? Vices in the educational sector. Should I show you another one? Injustice. Should I show you another one? There are many of them. You know them. Just think of any problem in society you see. Somebody sat down and built it. Pornography is a system somebody designed. Fashion, nudity is a system somebody designed. Secular songs, unwholesome videos, this is a system somebody designed. Facebook has taken more people to hell in the 21st century than just one whatever. Facebook is a system. The list is endless. Just think about any problem. Maybe we should mention some together. I'd like you to be interacted. What's one problem in society you think of? Let me show you how it came to pass or how it came to be. Yes, can you mention one? Terrorism is one. Hi. Gay. Same-sex marriage. Lesbianism. Bestiality. These are systems. And you know they create these things and they put it in channels. Media is driving it. Put it in government house. They make legislations to approve them. Just 2% of the world drives it. In America, it's just 4% of the entire population that is sponsoring gay. And a few people just put themselves together, organize themselves, and they sponsor a cause and put it on the table of the Congress. And it has to be approved. These few ones control society. Why everybody are victims of what they do? These few ones sit down. And the new world order, what do you think it is all about? Few people just sat down and drafted those things. What do you call IMF? World Bank? Do you know slavery is also a system? Somebody built slavery. It's a system. Now, let me round this thing up very quickly. What can the church do now to change society? Is it just in hosting crusades and all that and preaching and shouting? We have done that job for a long time and we have seen the results so far. Ragbonki can come now. Finish preaching. I mean, he has taught the whole Africa. He finished shouting and preaching and people make decisions for Christ. Yet, going to society, it looks like nothing is happening. Because what we don't know is that Rehoboam finishes with that crusade. People give their life to Christ. But the systems that reproduces the same problem is still in place. It's just like administering drugs now to somebody. And then maybe somebody who has malaria and all that. The person just feels temporarily okay. But you have not diagnosed the main problem or the root of the problem. Okay, it's just like going into beer parlors now. And because I'm passionate about stopping alcoholism in Nigeria, start breaking all the bottles. Imagine how many can I do? Walk into Waterworks Road now. Just walk as Mama G's beer parlor. And I'm just breaking the bottles. I hate beer. Those of you who drink beer, you go to hell. And I'm breaking all the bottles. My friend, if I am too strong, I mobilize the church. Let's say we are 50,000 people. I mobilize the whole church and we enter into the street and we break all the beers in all the beer parlors in Abakaliki. I don't need to wait for 2 days. Just the following day, the whole place will be filled with beers again. You know why? Because if you want to close down beer parlors, the problem is not the beer parlors or the bottles. The problem is the factory. There's a factory responsible. That thing is called the environment. It's 50%. It's too powerful. If you carry your Christianity without knowing how to build systems, without studying a problem and building and deploying a system, you are not going to solve that problem. So, believers, people give their life to Christ. They get born again. After some weeks, they backslide. Why? System. Okay, look at what Jay-Z is doing. Entertainment, Beyonce, Chris Morgan, and all that. They are building channels, Ben Bruce, Cartoon Channel, Disney World, and all those stuff. They are building all kinds of things. And people are bombarded daily with all kinds of nonsense. Okay, look at Facebook, social media, putting all kinds of rubbish. And people's eyes cannot see holy things. You go to the internet. Sometimes I open my internet and all that. And I see some stuff I didn't request. It has happened to me. I just get on email. And one naked girl is just standing and staring at me in the face. And I have to click delete for the stuff to go. There are some that even just hide somewhere, they won't go. Somebody created Google. And he designs it the way he wants. Somebody created. These things are systems. Which problem have you seen in society? If you can only settle down and build an alternative system. What is amazing is that the people who are doing it are small boys and girls. Don't think they are old people. They are young people. Can't you see Mark Zuckerberg? Can't you see, give me their names. You know these young guys and all that. Can't you see them? They are the ones ruling the world now. Apple is a system. iPad, Steve Jobs Corporation. Look at small children have phones in their hand. Every small guy now has a phone. Every small girl in school. Can you see now it's not hard to corrupt children? Stop them from going for nightclub. You won't go out. Stay in this house. Stay in this house. They say, no problem. Satan says, no problem. You can keep your child at home, but I'll bring the nightclub to the house. So there's DSTV now with crazy channels. Don't go nightclub, but you can see it at home. No, you don't wear skimpy things in this house. No problem. I'll bring the skimpy things to the house. So he brings the mini, he brings all the nonsense, brings all the stupid dressings, and he puts it on the channels. And you are off at work, working. Do you know even your offices are systems created by people? You wake up 8 o'clock, you're in the office, 4, you are back. It's a system, it's just running, and your life is running around it. And these guys are home watching all this nonsense. Before you notice it, these guys go haywire. So they go to maybe boarding school or they go to the university. By the time they are back, you wonder where they learned it from. It's in your house they learned it. They didn't learn it outside. That's why as Christians, you must be smart to understand. In my house, you can't play some kind of crazy channels. Even on the internet, there are softwares I would use to block out all the crazy whatever sites. Can't pop up. So these children can be whole. The world is crazy now. Even as an adult, you must watch what you are watching. But the way now to control the environment is for the church to sit down and start developing systems. Start developing concepts. Start coming up with. Do you know to build a school as an individual, as a church, is one way to solve the problem of vices, this immorality, high level of decadence in our secondary schools? To build a school is a way out of that problem. Because anything you see going wrong in society, just copy the system. Take the vices out of it. Put God's values into it. You have solved that problem. So you can see what Covenant University is doing, for instance. Where in EBSU, in Benin, and all those other places, you can go to school naked and do whatever you want. In Covenant University, it's the same university. Perhaps, possibly, the same courses, the same credit load, the same all of that. Same, maybe, the standard of education there may be higher and all that. But you see, there's values in that school. There's a way you can't dress on that campus. You'll be disciplined. So you say, I'm on campus now. Covenant University tells you that you're on campus. Doesn't mean you should be stupid. Doesn't mean you should be immoral. So they put codes of conduct. They put principles. They put rules and regulations to regulate the behavior of people there. There are times you cannot come into the hostel. There are clothes you can't put on. You can't even smoke. You can't drink. You can't do. There are systems, even chapel, all of those stuffs. There's a discipleship system. Some of those stuff for raising these young people. So if the church discovered this thing, because what we were doing those days was that we're stopping our children. Or, well, hey, the TV is a box of the devil. Don't watch TV and all that. Was it good? Yes, okay, it's all right. Because I know we were trying to protect our children from seeing nonsense and getting corrupted. But we were not building alternatives for them. That was the only option they had. If the church learns how to function here, we will take control of our society. What is amazing is that it takes hard work. But you need to know how to sit down at it. What problem are you passionate about solving? Let me get one or two responses, then we'll close. Who has a problem he has found out in society? And you are shocked. Pastor, I am called to solve this problem. Yes, give him the mic. Let's talk, let's talk. Let's interact. Get the mic quickly, give to him. Let's talk. That is one of the things Sunday Adelaja has been able to achieve in Ukraine. A church. But that church is a conglomerate of ministries. Because this whole thing I've been talking about systems is a call to go and fulfill your kingly ministry. And you can't fulfill it on your own. That ministry can only be fulfilled when we are interdependent. When we are a unified or a united force. Yes, let me hear you.
I've noticed serious issues in the entertainment sector. I don't want to start talking about the academic sector. Sometimes I sit down and ask myself, must every song be noisy? Must every comedy carry vulgar languages? Must every MC be a crazy person? Mm-hmm. Can't these people be decent? Can't we have Christian comedians who will still, when I listen to some of these Alibaba, Basket Mouth, and they are telling me that for a show, ₦1 million. And I'm asking myself, where are the Christian comedians? What are we doing? What are they doing? I see Christian singers. I remember the likes of Panam Passipor when he started. Today, where is he now? Why don't we hear him? Because there are many WizKids. There are many other people there, and Christians are the ones buying their CDs. That's what annoys me most. So this is something I've really seen in the society that needs addressing.
To solve that problem, you need discipline to build another kind of system. It's a big problem. We have slept for so long. That is why anytime you see me talking to those of you who are coming, I tell you, keep thinking I'm calling you to come and be a member of a church. I'm not calling you to be a member of a church. I'm calling you to become the world's number one most effective church of transformed priests and kings. And value-based global leaders who are passionate in the worship of God and endlessly committed to the propagating of his kingdom in all nations of the world. What is nations? Systems. Spheres of society. Through the preaching of the uncompromised and infallible gospel of the kingdom. The gospel of the kingdom. Do you know there's a gospel for the sports world? There's a gospel for the entertainment world. There's a gospel for them. There's a gospel for these sportsmen out there. Do you know what's going on in the... My goodness, there's this guy who jumped out of the church. And I don't want to mention his name because this is on record. The guy was a church guy. Check. Most of the guys who are doing entertainment now, church people. Check Harry's song. He's the one I'm talking about. Check Harry's song. Check check Banky W. Okay, check. P Square. Oh, there are many of them. Beyoncé. This one they killed the other time. What's her name? What's this lady's name? Whitney Houston. There are many. Check okay. Give me their names. You know them. R. Kelly. So plenty of them. Oh. Church people. We thought they were meant for choir. We didn't see society in the picture. So the devil took them out. Michael Jackson, church person. You see the way he destroyed him. Some of you are so passionate about what to eat and drink. What drives me is the environment. The Bible says we are the light of the world. How come the children of darkness are the ones that seem to be showing light now? Because we are good at playing church. We are not good at sitting down and building systems. And Christians have been enslaved in the world they are meant to take dominion in. If we can sit down and begin to build ministries, this is what system is all about. Build ministries. Develop ministries. Do you know that everywhere now, crazy magazines are everywhere. Hints, all this nonsense, fashions, displaying all kinds of... Which church person will sit down and design kingdom fashion and put it on magazines? People are reading rubbish. Which Christian, which kingdom will sit down and design these things and put it in society? That's why our calling as a church is unique and different. It's not something we are doing like any other person is doing. It's a ministry where everybody is rallied around and your ministry is deployed, is developed. That's why you have this other one. Because this is the 3D level of your relevance in life. If you want to become relevant, look at this 3D level. That's with discovery. Every one of you have an assignment God created to achieve in society. You're not just born to occupy a space. You are saved to be a savior. Christ didn't save you so you can go to heaven alone. He saved you so you can occupy on earth. You can bring down those high things, those imaginations that exalt itself above the knowledge of God. Pornography is a knowledge that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. What is this? Gay tells you that to sleep with a man now is the life. A man sleeping with a fellow man, it exalts them above the knowledge of God. That's what that scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5 is talking about. Casting down all imagination and bringing down all high things that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. There's a Bible now called Queen James Bible. Queen James, not King James. Oh, Queen James Bible is the opposite of King James. So everything God said don't do, Queen James say do. God say abstain from. He says, no, do. It's all right. Nothing is wrong with it. That's the Bible that legislates, that officially or religiously tells you it's not the problem. So now in America, you have pastors, even in Africa now. The other day in Ireland, I think about 80% or thereabout of the population of Ireland, Christians now, you are free. It's a law now in that country. And it's coming with speed to this part of the world and all that. You know, people are saying, no, it's religiously okay. You won't go to hell. A fellow man can marry a fellow man. They are putting it on CNN. Do you know how many nations of the world CNN is covering? They do interviews. Oprah Winfrey is doing interviews. People are watching it. And these guys are spreading these lies all over the world. We need people who would bring down those imaginations. It's not in shouting too much. It's in putting systems. Putting systems in place. People who will sit down and develop ministries. What is happening to the world of women out there? What is going on? What are the problems peculiar to women? We need, these are the times the Bible talked about, that in the last days I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see vision. What vision are you seeing for a problem out there? Can you sit down and take the pain? Yours may not be to start a church. That's why you need a place like this to be trained for your ministry. Ministry can be NGO. NGO reaching out the world of prostitution. There's a high level of exportation now of prostitutes in Nigeria. Go to Edo State. Every day they are exporting girls. Exporting girls. That, exporting them. Exporting them. They are going to Italy. Some of them are going to Dubai. What are they going to do? Prostitution to go and sell their body. And there are laws that legislated them and makes them okay. Abortion. Same sex. And they are putting this thing in schools. In secondary schools now, they are gay guys. They are gay ladies now.
Don't be shocked. Don't think this is. They are in Abakaliki as I speak to you. They are happening around. But the church failed at this stuff because we're busy preaching. We're busy raising good Christians. We didn't build systems. So in it is, for instance, what our mission says, to deliver and disciple every believer into the stature of Christ, the maturity, both mental, spiritual, and social. And by so doing, release a united body of transformational leaders. Not to keep them in the church, release them into society with a strong sense of purpose and ministry to all spheres of society. So there are people we should release from church to go and take over government house. Go and change political parties. Imagine that. Do you know church can build political parties? We can build political parties. We can register political parties. We can build schools, even universities. We can build satellites. We can build radio programs. One man, I think the previous regime, banned programs on TV, on radio. Why? He was in charge of the system. He controls the environment. That one is government's property. What if we have our own property? Will you ban my own? If Preston Hills built a TV station and a radio, will you ban my this thing? I think last time I was watching on TV, stupid Nollywood stuff. It was in your house. I was seeing that on African Magic. Innocently, just watching on Sunday. So stupid girls, just on the TV. You know, I can't even use those on who's... They use it, it smells, and I like this thing playing in this house. Do you know how many houses it's playing now? And do you know how many children are watching this thing now? Well, imagine churches understood this thing, and we took the media and we filled it with all kinds of Christian programs, maybe not just preaching. We design healthy programs, entertainment programs that can fill the minds of people and edify their spirit. The devil will have no place to sell in the market. Rise on your feet. Or maybe one person has one more thing to say. Okay. Let me take one or two more, then we'll close. There's no time. We're overshooting already.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to talk more about display. You know, most of times, we Christians, we fail in that area of discipline. Mm-hmm. We try to copy what we are meant to stand ourselves.
Let me show you something before he continues. This one that deals with discipline is what you need to go through this circle. Follow, I showed you there are three. If you look at this stuff, you see there are three. If you miss any of these, if you discover your ministry and you don't allow yourself to go through this circle, what do you call this one? It's called metamorphosis. Metamorphosis, that's development. A butterfly is not born as a butterfly, it's born as a larva. Is that correct? Sorry, you continue. Stand up, Ike. You continue. A butterfly is not born. When a butterfly is born at this discovery stage, it's a larva. A lot of you have great ministries locked up in you, but this one. And it takes discipline to go through development. Now, after development, what takes place now is deployment. Deployment is what you call manifestation. The endless expectation of creation. Now waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. It is after you have gone through this cycle, this one happens. Yes, conclude so we can pray.
When you look at the other side of religion, I mean, in the area, this so-called Muslim.
Okay.
You know, you can find out that their discipline is quite different from that of...
Okay.
You know, put their children right from the beginning. You can see that they create... a different background entirely. A Muslim father who so-called himself a Muslim, you can see the person, he cannot allow his or her daughter or his son to go out anyhow. And you see the kind of school then put them right from time, it will just give them the image of Muslim right from beginning. When you go outside country, like, let me say, like Dubai, if you go to Dubai, it hardly before you see women outside. I mean, the main Muslim, the so-called indigenous who are Muslim, is very, very hard before you see their female outside. And when you see them outside, you can't see them coming out with all these crazy wears. But in Christians, you come out in Nigeria, which... we claim to called Christian that dominated other religions. You see us, we can't display ourselves. The pastor can only talk, but the decision is yours. If after preaching here, we learned all these things and we go out there, we didn't take decision that this is what I have to do in order to affect my generation. You can't do nothing. These words that we're listing, all these things, all this talk, is just nothing. But when you take a decision that this is where I stand, in the area of, I can listen to radio, but when I see any wrong preaching or any wrong in television, when I see anything bad that is opposite to my belief, I can switch it off. Mm-hmm. You cannot do it. Mm-hmm. You see them, they will say, is it not a small time this thing will go? So we need to discipline ourselves to take some certain decisions which can make us to affect our environment.
Thank you. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. I would not give more time for more people. I know you want to stay more on this, but this is going to continue. Maybe on Sunday. Maybe on Sunday I'll continue on this. So let's leave it here now. Just put down those things you want to put down. On Sunday we'll continue on these issues. We'll get into more practicals of it, and we would be, by God's grace, able to come up with something. Everybody's ministry is going to come alive. Hallelujah. A program took place in Aba some times back, a mega church in Nigeria. They had a program and the whole place was filled. Millions of people attended the program, and they discovered the hotels where they lodged. The managers of hotels were giving a report that in that hotel, during that program, that the highest amount of used condoms were found. Now, this is church program. A whole city was filled with millions of people. A mega church in Nigeria had that crusade. And managers were reporting that this has never happened. Star Trek has done program here. This one has done program. We have never recorded the highest amount of condoms that were used in this hotel, like the one that was used by ministers and church people who were lodged in these programs. This is where it comes. 40%. We have this one, Boku. This one, we don't have it. Most of us have this one, but this one. The way to solve that problem is to build system, discipleship system. It starts from the church. Rise to your feet. Let's pray. There's no time. I just feel this burning passion in my spirit. I wish I could go on and on this. I lift up your voice. Just talk to God. If something is changing in your life, then talk to God. These are times to be relevant in society. Just talk. Talk to God in one minute. Sincerely. Don't get lost in the environment. Control it. Don't get lost in the crowd. Don't get lost in the crowd. You can take charge of the environment. Let me hear you pray. Lift up your voice. Pray. A lot of believers are living irrelevant lives. Why? They don't know these things. And they were not properly taught. Wrong teachings everywhere. Wrong teachings. Father, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, listen, let the instrument stop. Listen, this is important. This is not the season to play with your Christianity. If you can't pray, I don't know what you're doing here. If you're asked to pray and you can't pray, then I don't know what you're doing here. Go and join the world out there. If I am a Muslim, if I'm a Muslim, I'll do more havoc than what is this my friend's name in Boko Haram. What's his name? Shakao is doing. I will do more. You know why? Because I'll have a team of people who, when I spark them with one, they are ready to run and take nations. Not this one, when you finish sparking you are still looking and moping at me. Do you know what drives me now? It's not longer about me now. It's the world Jesus died for. Christianity is the greatest cult. It's the greatest fraternity. It can't be taken lightly. We are cultsmen. We are cultists. There's no cult group that is higher than this one called Christianity. Some of you play light. You play light of it. You take it lightly and for granted. You need to rediscover your place back in Christ, though. You're not just living here for living sake. Church is copying the world now. Look at everything going on in the world. Come to church, you will see it. Hairstyle. We are copying the world's hairstyle. Dressing, we are copying the words. The people who are modeling us, which one are we modeling to the church? common entertainment industry. Go to Lagos, go to Abuja. All the billboards, the people you see there, not one is a Christian. Check Globe billboards. Check MTN billboards. Even common thing tomato, which Christian do you see? They advertise Maggi, they carry flavor and put it everywhere. And flavor is a model. Flavor is a model. He's a model. He's a model for people. They put Helen Paul, she's a model. They bring Funke, she's a model. That's what they are telling the world. So Glow has ambassadors. How many ambassadors of Glow are Christians? SP Square, he's a model for them. What are you doing with your own Christianity? I came to charge you, my friend. Stop being torn and stop being nominal. If your Christianity cannot influence society, there's a market for you. Go and join them full time. The same things you patronize. They carry worldly guys, unbelievers, and they fill the whole thing. And you're okay with it. The soap you use, how many Christians are on it? Because they see Christianity as a religion. Make a dedication back to God. Say, Father, use me the way you want. I'm dedicating myself back to you again. No more will I play with my Christianity. I'm going to let my life so shine. It's going to so shine that the world will see my good works and glorify you in heaven. This light of mine is going to shine. I can't play with my life anymore. Can't be like them out there. When they bring anything that has to do with the church, on newspaper, on social media, it's one castigation or the other. When they bring anything that has to do with church, it's one castigation. When they bring Toto Dike, it's about her wedding. They are putting her on newspaper, putting her on Facebook. Toto Dike gets wedded, gets wedded. They are celebrating them. They call them celebrities. Which one are they calling you? We're busy doing religion. It's time to tell ourselves the truth and come out from that dead religion. Religion that won't change society. Religion that won't change our world. A lot of Christians in churches, professing Christians, yet the lights of their Christianity are dead. It's dead. Balagala balagala laboshan. Bogo bobo. Ragabala balagala laboshata. Rabababagabala laboshandia. The highest level of excuse is in church. We bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. In the name of Jesus. When you go home tonight, pray. Ask God to fill you. This is your best time for relevance. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Ask God to open your eyes. When you go home, pray. Don't be distracted. If there's any temporal or momentary thing that is distracting you, cut it off. Cut it off. Cut it off. If you're in this church, you know anybody who is always giving excuses, this is time to go and set that person on fire. Lay hands on that person and let the fire of this thing come on him. If you're a leader in church, don't take these things lightly. You are worse than a Boko Haram. You can't disciple people. Why? Because you don't understand your identity. If you are sick in this house, just come. Let me pray for you quickly. Just come up right now. Come up right now. Let me pray for you. Those of you who have one ailment or the other, come. Why should Christians be the ones who are victims of all kinds of nonsense? Why? Because we have lost our identity in Christ. Lift up your hands right now. Holy Ghost, feel these ones. Now, as I pray for you, now you're going to get healed, but at the same time, fire is going to come back to you. You can't be sick. Not when you know your identity in Christ. Why are you sick? You can't be sick. I don't know how many times they do altar call in the mosques for sick people. Father, in the name of Jesus, receive your healing right now. Let fire come so mightily into your bones. Fire that would cause you to become a voice to the world. Right now. Right now. I break every infirmity. I destroy every infirmity. Then I release you to your ministry. To your ministry right now. Become a voice in your generation. Holy Ghost, right now. I release the anointing on this one. No more shall sickness dwell in your mortal bodies. I dry every virus in your system. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. I cause it to dry right now. And let the fire of revival come back to you. Like never before. In the name of Jesus Christ. The rest of you lift up your hands. Father, I pray for everyone right now. I pray that the ministries of everybody in this house will be unlocked. Everybody.
everybody here will become a voice to his nation. Will become a voice for this generation. No more sleeping tents. No more every sleeping tent. I curse you to wake up right now. I curse you to wake up. Right now. I curse every sleeping tent. Right now. I curse every sleeping tent. Let him wake up right now. Enough is enough. Go and rule your world. Have dominion in your world right now. Change the stress of your society. Become a trailblazer. Become a trailblazer. No more torness. The time for the revival of the church has come. The time to revive the church. To awaken the church from slumber. That time has come. Over. I release you into your ministry right now. Every gift God has put in you, refined by the Holy Ghost. By the Holy Ghost. Jesus. Now, one of the things that will start happening to those of you see, it takes hunger and thirst to pursue the kingdom. Pursuing God's kingdom is not pursuing heaven. Pursuing God's kingdom is working hard to see that kingdom infiltrates the whole world. It takes people who are hungry. Listen to me. Let me tell you something. For the fact I am here, evil cannot thrive in my world. That's the mindset I have. People cannot go to hell because I'm here. These are not times to, you know, I went for a program somewhere. I left the office. I was going. I saw a big billboard, one prophetic program or whatever. And people were talking what I don't understand. There's a witch in your village. This one, that one. I said, what is all this? There are bigger witches in society. Who is binding the power of pornography? You are binding. Hey. Can I show you this? Listen to this. 20% of the devil's power actually is spiritual. 80% of the power of the devil is systemic. I don't know what you are binding. You keep binding devils and all that. When the Bible says we are seated in heavenly places, far above principalities and power, and you are binding what? 80% of the power of the devil is systemic. 80% of the power of the devil is in pornography. 80% of the power of the devil is in terrorism. 80% of the power of the devil is in Facebook. Don't think it's in your village. That one is easy to take care of. The devil cannot perch on me. Once I have the anointing and the blood of Jesus on my life, the devil can't perch on me. But when your TV sets are not whole, with your anointing and the blood, you can still fall into that sin. That's why we need what it takes to build systems. From tonight, some of you are going to be seeing visions, revelations on how to become indispensable. This coldness you have been called for so long, it's time to become relevant to your world. It's time to discover how to become a voice to the world. It's time to discover it. How to become a voice to the world. There's a sleeping giant in you. That giant is coming up right now. It's waking up. When a David discovers he's not just a shepherd boy, he goes back to Pharaoh, goes back to Goliath as a killer of a giant. Goliath is not just a spiritual problem. It's a social problem also. There are a lot of Goliaths in society waiting for Davids to kill them. Where are the Davids for this generation? Where are the Gideons for this generation?
Where are the Esthers for this generation? Where are they? Where are they? Where are they? A lot of Samsons have their eyes blindfolded because of the things of this world. You cannot lay on Delilah's lap and wake up on Abraham's bosom. A lot of Samsons are sleeping on the laps of Delilah, sleeping on the laps of the cares of this world, and their eyes have been blindfolded. Their eyes have been taken. That's why they don't have visions. They can't see beyond the current stage of their life. We give you praise. We give you glory. Hallelujah. When Kumuyi came to Abakaliki, I was in the stadium. When Pastor Kumuyi came to Abakaliki, I was in the stadium. I witnessed the crowd. I witnessed his preaching and all that. And I looked at Kumuyi. I said, this man has been in the field for many years now. I looked at Adeboye. Adeboye has been in the field for many years now. I said, this man by now should be resting and watching us play the game. Up till just a few months ago, Adeboye is still saying that the man who is going to succeed him when he goes is not yet in redeem. Adeboye is still saying that the man who will succeed him is in the beer parlor. So with all the Christians in redeem, no one person to succeed Adeboye, there's a problem. And God said, look at them. He ministered to me. Just take it down a little. He said, look at him. I said, look at Adeboye. He said, these are fathers of the faith. They have done great jobs. But your generation has a greater job to do. He said, like Moses, who brought the children of Israel out of Egypt, Joshua has a greater responsibility. His own is to take them in. So those of you who are still looking at Adeboye, still looking at Kumuyi, still looking at David Oyedepo and all that, their attention is on you, even you don't know it. Imagine a whole God who is able to do anything. He was the one in heaven asking, who is going to go for us? Who will I send? Who will go? That is what Almighty God was asking. That's the same question these guys, most of these generals, are asking. What is going on in your generation? Some of us even seem to understand the generation more than them. I seem to understand my generation even more than them. If Adeboye walks into an Oba's palace now, he knows what to tell the Oba to get the guy saved. His ministry is for a class of people. If he comes out to a secondary school now or a university to talk to students, he can talk, but he may not be able to find out those peculiar issues. Me who interacts with them may understand it more. And some of you here understand it. Why are you sitting down? And religion has filled you up. What impact have you been able to create? Time will fail me. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you praise. Thank you, Father. If there's anything distracting you, I want to beg you. It's a decision I made. If it's a lady, you are a guy. If it's a girlfriend, cut off. If it's a boyfriend, cut off. It will cut short your destiny. Cut off. Whatever. Maybe it's a company of friends. Cut off. Every day I wake up, I know I am the hope of the world. I'm the hope of... In November, I'm going to be in the U.S. I'm going to be speaking in Dallas, Texas. I know. I've been following some people online. Some people have been following me online. Some white kids in Texas. And some of the things they are going through, you know these guys need help. And the questions they're asking me, you know this guy, even their parents. Obama cannot help. Obama cannot. He can't help them. He doesn't know it. He's busy legislating abortion and all that. He can't help them. And there's this cloud of spiritual coldness in the U.S. now. The same nation that exported Christianity to the world is the same one now legislating gay. Look at what is happening in the black race. 80% of black people are once locked up in prisons all over the world. Our male children. I was driving towards Tycoon. One, an ex-convict ran out. He told me, he said, Pastor, anything you find me, I will eat. Even if it's 10 naira. Anything you find me, I will eat. Hey, I want to eat Gary. Oh, because he was talking. I looked at him. Igbo has so scattered his brain. Prison has so bastardized him. And I felt tears in my heart.
I say, imagine this one was my younger brother. I say, imagine this one was me. And God is gracious to have saved me. I am now in the world of light. And I cannot deploy that light to people who are in darkness. I'm not worth leaving them. If your living is waking up in the morning and just wearing good clothes and going to a restaurant to eat a good food and going back home and strolling out, if that is all you are here to do, then you failed. You failed. There's more to that. There's a problem waiting for you in society. Can you reach out that problem? Who can reach out those guys in the prison? Who can reach them out? I vowed I will not be obscure. I don't know about you. It's not because I'm a pastor. I can't be obscure. In this generation, no, they will hear my voice. I can't. Gay cannot survive with me here. He can't survive. He can't survive. Prostitution, no, he can't. What if it was my daughter? He can't survive. That's why there's no dumb man for me. I'm always on fire. You can't catch me complaining. I'm depressed. I feel weak. I don't feel like going to church. I don't feel. You can't catch me that way. Glory to God. Take up your offerings. Let's give to God. Just take up your offerings. Just take up your offerings. Let's give to God. Father, we thank you for offerings. We give you praise. We give you glory. We don't feel like going, Lord. We just feel like staying in your presence. But Lord, let these things we have heard, let these teachings we've received, let these words we've heard, let it not fall by the wayside. Let it yield in us what it takes. Let it yield in us. Let it yield in us what it takes, Lord. Produce the virtue, the drive, everything it takes to be committed to this commission, committed to our assignments in life. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray.
We believe you've been transformed by the wonders of God's Word. For additional information about us, you can visit our website at www.princetonhills.org. You can also send us a mail at info@princetonhills.org or call 0806-499-5029, 0812-511-3214. Princeton Hills Ministries, raising global leaders.